we're here at the Salmon River. This is a rotary screw trap. This is one of four that we're running this year. This year we're doing the Salmon River, Still Creek, Clear Fork of the Sandy, and the Lost Creek. Since 1992, we have done Still Creek every single year. So that's the one that we keep in place always, every single year, and then the other ones rotate around. These are out-migrating smolts, so they're on their way. They're juvenile, 1, 2, 3-year-old fish on their way out to the ocean. This is volutionarily spinning them into this live well where we catch them, and they stay in here. We check the trap every single morning, and if we know that there's gonna be a lot of fish, we'll come and check later in the afternoon to make sure it's not too full. We also, in conjunction with ODFW in the fall, do spawning surveys with the adult fish that are coming in. And by using both of them, we can get really good population estimates on our streams here on Mount Hood. We're trying to catch as many coho and steelhead as possible. We mark 25 of each target species, and then we take them upstream, we mark them with a special paint that stays on between 1 and 2 weeks. And we mark 25 of each target species, we take them upstream a quarter mile, and then we try to recapture them in this smolt trap. And then by determining our efficiency of how well we're capturing the fish in smolt trap, we can then extrapolate an overall population estimate for both steelhead and coho.
Okay, we've got a coho smolt. 110 millimeters. 16.7 grams.
16.7.
Give them a bath, check the mark. Mark is good. Right back into cold, fresh water. Mark is good.
The historic populations in these streams were much larger than they are now. Of course, humans and dams and all a few other things. Water quality has hurt populations overall. So first off, we'd like to see the populations get back to historic numbers. We're definitely out here trying to help the population. And the overall goal would be to have people be able to fish for the fish and be able to take them home. But we're also here just to revive these populations and keep them going. It's, you know, any species, you don't want them to become endangered and go away. Everybody remembers when they were a kid, especially people that live here, that they had a bunch of fish spawning at their house, and we work really hard at it.
I would like to just say that we are seeing results, and just in the few years that Josh has been here, he's already seeing an increase in the populations. So it's backing up our initiative to do this habitat restoration. To me, it matters because we're making a difference. What we're doing matters. We're rehabilitating the streams and bringing these populations back up so that people do have a chance to catch fish and there are fish for the future.
Well, I grew up in Michigan and I fished a little bit on the lakes around my house. And then I moved to Montana, and one day I was driving up the stream and it was a beautiful sunny day. And I saw this guy standing in the middle of the river fly fishing. And it was gorgeous. I mean, straight from river runs through it. You know, he had his dog out there with him. And so I was like, I want to learn how to fly fish. So I started learning how to fly fish, and I got really into fishing, and I really, really loved it. And I saw that populations were having, you know, I'd heard it was harder to catch fish than it used to be. There's all the fish stories, big stringers of fish. So I really got into wanting to help the populations out. It's hard sometimes to see what we're doing and how it's helping, but you can see it in the numbers. So why we're doing these out-migrating smolt studies and monitoring, because if you're not monitoring, then you won't know what's really happening. And then someday you'll be like, what happened to that fish? And if we didn't pay attention to it, we would never know.